Now, one of my most disliked saying that I hear that has hurt so many hunters throughout the years from destroying hunting opportunities is that you can't shoot deer sitting on the couch. And that's under the premise that the more you go out, the more deer you're gonna see. And you can't shoot them sitting at home. And that couldn't be further from the truth. That has saved so many deer out there throughout the years. It's very, very bad advice. And I'm gonna talk about several reasons right here, but I'll point out number one. I hope all of you that like hunting every day out there are my neighbors, because you're gonna push the deer off your land into the lands that I hunt. And it's almost an unfair advantage. The more you go out, the more opportunity I have. The more you go out, the more neighbors, your neighbor's opportunity is increased. Because if they're being patient and hunting smart, then they're going to see a lot more deer because you're spooking them off your land. And the most reactive deer to pressure are mature bucks. Mature does are somewhere in there, but I would say a middle-aged buck is more reactive than a mature doe too. Mature does are herd mentality. They think as a group, they group think. They have very small home ranges. So when they're spooked, they don't go far. As long as they have high quality food, decent cover, they're going to be there. Not even great cover, not even great food. They're going to be there for months at a time. That's why if does and fawns are there during the summer, does and fawns that are here today are here to stay. Does that are there during the summer will stay into that habitat during the fall. And that can be a bad thing when you're trying to manage bucks and you're trying to manage quality herd, because the more does you have on the land, the fewer bucks you're going to have on the land. If you don't have any does in the land, that means your property is unattractive, unattractive spot on public land. So there's a balance. There's always a balance to just about anything in life. And nothing could be more true than when you're hunting too much, it's an unfair advantage for everywhere else, everybody else around you, if they're actually hunting smart and not overdoing it. And think about this with poker. Is a good analogy with poker. You know, a good poker player, I am not. But a good poker player will fold more times than they're probably in actually entering that game and going in, because they feel like they can tactfully, whether they're bluffing, whether they have a good hand, they're going in at the right time to win that hand. And that's why it's not a game of total luck when it comes to poker, because smart players, whether you're a deer hunter or a poker player, know when to go in and know when to go into the woods, and when to lay their cards down and to play that hand that they're dealt. And if they're not dealt a good hand, they're just folding and moving on. They know that. Are you a good poker player? You have to play poker in the deal words. I talk about that all the time. But if you're not, it's an unfair advantage for everyone else around you, meaning they're gonna take advantage of you. They're gonna take your money. They're gonna take your opportunity if it's on deer land. They're gonna take your money at the poker table. Number two, when you're sitting on the couch and being smart and being patient, you're saving your best spots for the perfect sit. It's not to say you don't hunt around the edges. You don't hunt some public land somewhere nearby. You hunt your lower stands, your ones that you don't expect a lot in. But when you expect good weather, cold temperature drop, the conditions that I built on HuntCast as it relates to RutCast, to the whole combination of the RutCast and HuntCast on the HuntWise app, then when you have that perfect sit coming up and you save that stand in that area, boy, odds are really good. As long as you have the bucks there, you obviously have to have deer there. People go in and say, well, it's a good day, I went out in the woods. Well, you didn't have bucks, didn't have good sign in the area, you haven't had good sign, well, you can't expect good results. It's almost like playing poker without a hand. You gotta have some cards in there to actually do something with when the conditions are great. So you save your best spots for the perfect time. Number three, when you're sitting on the couch, you're not burning out a lot of things. You're not burning out your land, your stands, your family, your boss, your friends. You're not overdoing it. Again, going back to that balance thing. But it's crazy how when you allow good things to happen and you're patient and smart, you're not burning out. Then again, it goes back to this unfair advantage that you have versus everyone else around, because most people are pushing it too much. Number four, less equals more. As I've gotten older and I've gotten smarter and I've tried to do my best in the woods, I find that my mature buck opportunities are one out of every five sits, one out of every six sits, one out of every four, depends on the season. But the point is, I'm hunting the best days, and boy, they really, really pay off. And even looking at a weekend, again, I talk about slanting your time. So number five down here, You can improve your sits per buck ratio. I can remember a time where I shot two bucks at 110 times in 2006. I've gotten a lot smarter since then. I had 10, 12 all day sits, probably half the day in the wrong spot because I wasn't managing my morning stands versus evening stands. People say, oh, it's HuntWise says it's going to be a good day to hunt. I'll sit in the same stand all day. Well, in the pre-rut, you're probably wasting the whole middle of the day because bucks aren't moving. If you're sitting in a morning stand, you're wasting the afternoon because you're staying in the same stand all day. If you're sitting in an evening stand, you went in there in the morning, you probably bumped deer out because an evening stand relates to food. So you can really destroy your hunt even on a good day when you're not hunting that morning specific or evening specific stands. But you slant your opportunity for days off, with your family and friends, days off at work, leaving the family to go hunting. Slant towards the best days. Now you're maximizing your time. That's why I did this to begin with. I didn't have much date. I had 2 weeks off. Didn't have much money. Slept in the car a lot. You know, you talk about trail cameras. Now we have 35 trail cameras out there. And that's a lot different than 10, 15 years ago when my buddy Carl would buy trail cameras, you know, 4 new trail cameras for the year. And I did all the work on the land, and that was a good trade-off. I got trail cameras for my birthday, for Christmas, tree stands. What do you want for your birthday? My mom would say, my dad. How about a tree stand? Trail camera, if I could throw that in there, being greedy. But bottom line is, that's how I accumulated trail cameras, tree stands. How I was able to do those things. And I made that choice. Do I want to be in a bowling league, or do I want to lease land for $1,000 and then travel down and be able to hunt it? I made those choices, but I always slanted my time so that I could hunt on that Friday instead of a Monday off, because the Friday was a better weather day and Monday was terrible. Or I hunted Monday instead of Friday because Monday was the better weather day and not on Friday. That's why I came up with this algorithm in the past. That's why I wanted to do this. That's why I hunt the weather and a half for 30 years, because I wanted to maximize my time afield. And I knew that hunting bad days and just having that attitude of every day I can go out in the woods, I never agreed with that. It's probably because I didn't have anyone in my family that hunted. My brother and I hunted on our own. We asked for bows for Christmas in about 1984, 85. When we started hunting, we grew up in a fishing family. So I had no one tell me, you need to get out in the woods. Can't kill them from the couch. I didn't have any of these dumb sayings leading me astray. In fact, we tried to figure things out on our own. And that, in the end, I think made me a better learner. And it allowed me to gain a better amount of experience because I had to try everything. I had to try all these different experiences. Know what worked, what didn't. I didn't have someone pounding in my head that you have to do it this way. And then I didn't learn anything else because I didn't try it another way. Always can slant your time towards the best time. That's what I did when I would take a half day off at a time out of my 2 weeks vacation where I worked at the bank. They allowed me to take a Thursday afternoon off, and then the bank was open from 7 to 7. That means I could come in by 11 the next day. It means I could sit for 2 hours in the morning, drive an hour and 45 minutes straight to work, go to work, and I still got to hunt an evening and a morning by only taking a half day off. And then the weekend was bad, so I did something else. Or Sunday was better than Saturday, so I hunted Sunday afternoon, Sunday instead of Saturday, and that's how I hunted. I just always looked at the best days, and I did that on a budget. I did it with not much money and not much time off, working for bad pay in an area where I didn't make a lot of money. I still managed. There's another video we're going to create of hunting on a budget, and that's how we did this. Again, I have a bunch of trail cameras now, but things have changed over the years drastically from what it was in the early 90s to the 2000s and up through where we're at right now in 2021. But I always slant my days. Now, when I don't go hunting, I work. I have to get things done. And I work a lot of hours per week. I put out 4 videos a week, Tuesday, Thursday, Saturday, and Sunday morning. When we were fishing in Canada last week, I still drove in to get cell service Tuesday, Thursday, Saturday, Sunday, and Tuesday morning again. Because I have to put those videos out. I try to spend a half hour, 45 minutes answering comments, and I go do it again in the evening. So even on my days off, my vacation, I'm still working hard. It's amazing how when you work hard in the right direction by hunting smart, how good things happen. And good things are going to happen when you sit your rear end on the couch and make smart decisions on going all in as opposed to folding, knowing when to say when to go in, and hunting smart with a defined purpose when you go to the stand on a certain buck, or a certain doe you're after, a deer in general, whatever it is, you'll be rewarded by being patient and smart and spending more time on the couch. You'll see your ratios get better for when you're actually out in the woods. And you know the cool thing is? You'll probably be able to spend more time with family, friends, and not tick your boss off in the process. It's Spend more time on the couch this fall and you'll find more success for not only this fall, but every fall and every deer season beyond. Folks, I want to make sure you check out my web class video series, whether it's how to design your food plot program or how to design your property in general. And we have a new one coming out that'll be how to hunt the rut. But these bucks back here are testament. Some of these bucks go back to 93. They're even in different states. I urge you to check out those web classes that you can help yourself, help your land, help your hunt. The link is in the description. And also for those that have tried them out, I encourage you to offer some feedback in the comments below. Thank you.